Hello everybody, Isaac24 here, back with a product review this time. I'm sure a lot of my viewers know I drive an old car, by choice, mostly. And sometimes driving an old car, you don't get luxuries you would get in a newer car. This car is about to be 24 years old, and one of the things that it lacks that a lot of modern vehicles have that would be very nice to have is some way to input an auxiliary audio source. Either an auxiliary jack, a USB port, even a tape deck, because then I could put one of those adapters in. Now, this car does have a good old-fashioned CD player, which, while CDs are not my favorite, if this CD player worked, I very much would use it. That said, it does not work. So really, the only option for audio in this car is the AM/FM radio. Now, don't get me wrong, I love AM and FM radio, and I listen to it very frequently. That said, in my case, I have a playlist on my cell phone that is roughly 250, maybe 300 songs, and it is essentially all songs that I can listen to and like without skipping. I have a couple radio stations in my presets that are all great. Cruising 92.9, 94.9, 101.7, 106.1 for the Bob and Tom Show. If you're local, you'll know what all those are. They're basically all classic rock stations, with the exception of one that I have, which is 92.1, which is some hip-hop. But, you know, sometimes some hip-hop is good for you. But of course, even 92.9, which is an amazing radio station, once in a while will play a song by, say, Queen. I do not like Queen at all. Kill me for it, try to fight me, but I do not like Queen. So I changed the radio station. Well, it would be easier to just have a random assortment of songs play, and all of them I enjoy. And I have a solution for that. It's not a CD, but it does involve using my cell phone. And that is the good old-fashioned FM transmitter. I've known about these for a while, but I only recently decided to get one because I realized that good old Walmart sells this one for $10. And I saw it and I said, there is no way that this thing is going to be good at all, but let's try it. It's very small. You can see it has a little screen, two USB ports, some skip and seek track buttons, a phone button, the channel button, and a lighting button. So I will give you a demonstration of it. So the first thing we're going to do is we will turn the key on this car from off to the accessory position, which I believe the radio might come on. And it did. It's on 106.1. So what we will do is we will plug this into the cigarette lighter. Now in this car, you cannot plug it in straight up and down because the cigarette lighter area is too small. So we have to plug it in like this, but we'll plug it in nonetheless. Bluetooth, and now it is set to station 91.5, which on my phone, you will notice if we go into settings now, not that, oops, I'm going to have to edit that out, it automatically connects to the FM transmitter. Now 91.5 is the radio station I have selected for it, because if we unplug this and we go to 91.5, static. And it is pretty much consistently static anywhere I drive. So, because it's just static, plug the FM transmitter in. You heard it beep. Now we're going to have to turn the volume up a fair bit. Oops. But we'll go into the music app on my cell phone, and we'll play whatever the next song is up after Iron Maiden. And now, we have music playing from my phone through the Bluetooth on 91.5. Now, as you'll hear, it It is not the highest quality audio. It doesn't help that these two speakers are both shorted and only work sometimes. You can hear it up to that. So, it's certainly playing. Is it the best? No. And if I really wanted to get some good audio of it, I would drive around with it. That said, one thing I have noticed is it does get staticky and out while you are driving, unfortunately. It's really unavoidable what it does. So if that's a deal breaker for you and you don't like static, it's going to have staticky and it's going to go sometimes. That said, I will give you a little demonstration. While it's playing the song, if we hit the next button, it just switched songs to the next song. And if we hit the back button, right there, we already heard that song. So one thing I'll show you if we pause it is this channel button. We can change the station. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn this down a little and I'm going to go to another station that might just be static. That one has a bit of a reception. Nope. Nope. That's a good one. So we'll hit channel. Then we will arrow over to 90.7. If we go back to 91.5, let's see what happens. Nope, 91.5, so let's try channel. Oh, you know what? It must have to be within a certain frequency range, so let's try. That works. Let's try 96.9. Channel. That did it. So now, we'll hit play again. There you go. So yeah. I've never used the call button. I've actually never hit the light button. Let's see. I actually rather like not having the lights on, but it doesn't really matter. I got another idea. I'll be back in a second. Okay, I went ahead and moved it back to 91.5 because I like that one better. As you can see, it's playing the music. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to take this landline telephone and I'm going to see what happens. I'll put my phone right here if we call my number. So I will actually, I'm going to wait till the next song comes on because I want it to be like I want it to be normal. So we'll wait a second here. It's on random. It's also a good song. So, we will call my number. My number's on the screen. I'm not going to show it, but I will go ahead and hit call now.
One. Three.
Hello? Listen on here. Hi. Oh, it's going to put feedback on, isn't it? Hello? It says call. Oh. Hi. We're playing with it now. All right, now it's regular speakerphone. Actually, I'm going to exit the car and see what happens. Let me put my phone. Let's do that.
Hello? Hello. Alright. It seems like it's only coming through my phone, so let me change it here.
Hi. Test. Does this work? Not doing totally what I thought, to be honest. Ooh, you know what? I'm gonna try something else too. I'm gonna end this call. There's the music. Okay, I'm going to now. I'm gonna call again, but I'm gonna answer it on here. Call.
One, 5.
Hello? Hello? Hi. All right. It sounds, actually, you know what? I got a better idea. I'm gonna put my camera and my house phone, I'm gonna put them right here, and I'm gonna sit in the car and see what we can hear. The speaker phone.
Hello?
Hello?
I am talking
on my FM transmitter,
and hopefully you can hear me.
Yeah.
Hopefully it's got some good quality.
Subscribe to Isaac24.
This is the Saturn SL1 2000 model.
Ooh. I wish I had my Rick roll so I could Rick roll the damn telephone. That'd be pretty cool. But I'm just sitting with my phone in the same position as it was. So, if this is how it works normally, then I would say I'm going to move my phone up here. I'd say that's pretty damn impressive. Now, I'm going to get closer to the FM transmitter. This is me talking closely.
What?
Excuse me. Alright, I'm going to hit end. I open the door.
And I'm going to say goodbye.
Bye. That definitely worked. Here's the music. So it does make phone calls, okay. Oh, forgot to hang up. So it is a bit iffy, but, you know, it'll interrupt your music, it's playing. I'm not gonna test the charging function, because why bother? But, so overall, I would say, if you just want a cheap FM transmitter just to play some Bluetooth in your car, I mean, this is a pretty decent option, especially the fact that it can answer phone calls and the fact that you don't have to put your phone, you can do Bluetooth, you don't have to you don't need an aux jack. I would turn the song off, but it's such a damn good song. So, I'm headbanging, you just can't see it. But I mean, when I drive, my volume is more like this. I don't know about that loud. I would say like that, yeah. So, yeah, for an FM transmitter, it's not bad. Now, it does, if I do this while I'm driving, it will start staticking up. But for $10, I mean, we can turn the lights off too. I mean, I don't know how you can argue with that for $10. Pretty freaking sweet deal in my opinion, if you ask me. The only other ones I've seen, some of them have volume controls on them. But I mean, if you have your phone, you can just turn the volume down like this. Or back up. So, I don't think that that's a huge deal. But, $10 on FM transmitter. Playing Interstate Love Song, Bluetooth. So,
So, yeah, really not much to say here. There, this is the end of the song. This is good. What a song. So we'll pause it now. Obviously, when you're done with your FM transmitter, turn that down a little, pull it out, back to static, and back to a radio station. Whatever, pick a radio station. This car has a pretty good sound system, even with two speakers. I mean, I'll be honest. But you can hear how much clearer it is with just that. So, we'll actually do that, because I'm going to leave it on that for tomorrow. And we'll just turn the car off. So, that is, in conclusion, as I throw it on the ground, probably the cheapest FM transmitter you can buy. You get them at your local Walmart. I mean, it's hard to go wrong with one of these. Isaac24.com, as we said on the telephone. Goodbye, everybody.